Hello friend, welcome to Material Engineering Hub. This is Ravi Gupta. Today I'm going to talk about what is a safety valve, and after that I will talk about what is the difference between a safety valve and a relief valve. Okay, and after that through a diagram I will show you how the safety valve and the relief valve differ, and then I will show you that what do you mean by the lift of the safety valve and how much should be the lift and how it is calculated. So let's start the video. What is a safety valve? Basically, a safety valve is a device fitted into the boiler to release the excess pressure so that to prevent damage to the boiler casing and its component. So as you can see that basically this is the safety valve in the boiler. This safety valve is mounted onto the boiler steam drum so that if there is an excess of pressure, in that case it will release it instantaneously so that preventing damage to the boiler casing. For that purpose the safety valve is provided in a boiler and it is installed in a steam drum. Now the question comes to the mind that what are the set pressure of the safety valve. So basically safety valve is set to lift at a 3% above the design pressure and it sit back 5 to 10% below the design pressure. So what happens whenever this safety valve is lifted, at that time what happens, suppose the if a pressure design pressure is 10 bar, in that case safety valve will lift at 0.3% more than that, means 10.3. now what will happen basically that when the 10.3 pressure is reached, at that time the safety valve will lift and will release the excess pressure, but while relieving the excess pressure it will sit down when the pressure of the system fall below 5 to 10%, means if the 10 bar is the limit design pressure, it will lift at 10.3 bar and it will sit around 9.6 to 9.8 bar, so preventing frequent operation. Now the question second come to our mind, okay, we have seen safety valve, but what is the really difference between safety valve and relief valve? Basically the relief valve is provided to lift at the time of overpressurizing of the system and it will lift when a system pressure exceeds 10% above the design pressure, but it will sit back instant as the system pressure reaches the design pressure. So what do I mean by this is this, that this is the relief valve. Now basically relief valve and the safety valve function is the same, is that it will relieve the excess pressure developed in a system, but the mode of operation is different. Basically the relief valve operate when the design pressure slightly excess of design pressure is reached, means 10% above the setting pressure it is set, means if the design pressure is 100 then it is set at 110 it will lift, and after that what will happen, once it is lifted it will release the excess pressure, and once the pressure reaches the 100% it will again sit back. It means that it will operate 10% above the excess pressure and will sit back when the design pressure is reached. But in a case of a safety valve, it will operate 3% of the excess design pressure, but it will sit back 5 to 10% below the design pressure. So that is the difference, main difference between a safety valve and a relief valve, that the sitting is different, means it is seated so in 5 to 8% below the design pressure safety valve, because so that it avoids frequent operation of opening. But the relief valve is set in such a way that it can operate instantaneously whenever the pressure is exceeded, it sit only at 100% design pressure. Now same thing I have written here, but a safety valve will lift at 3% of excess of design pressure, but once when lifted it will sit back when the system pressure is 5 to 10% below the design pressure. So as you can see the same thing I have told you. Now the second question come to our mind, and it asks in MEO class 4, MEO class 2, that what do you mean by the lift of a safety valve. So what do you mean by that? When a safety valve is lifted due to overpressurizing, the path provided by the valve by lifting to allow the excess steam to flow without any hindrance is called lifting of safety valve. So it's very clear. It means what? That whenever the valve is lifted against the excess pressure, at that time the path provided by the valve of opening this path. This path is called lifting of a safety valve. Means without any hindrance, we are providing a path for the excess steam to release. That excess steam is released into the atmosphere and the system is prevented from overpressurizing. The path which is providing by operation of the valve, that is called lifting of a valve. Now the question comes, second question is asked, that what is the ideal lifting of a valve, safety valve? So how much will be the lift of a safety valve? So basically the a formula is given for calculation of the lifting of safety valve. So as you can see, first before starting the formula, once more thing I want to tell you, this is the safety valve bonnet where the steam will flow, and this is the valve which is sitting on the surface. Now the lifting area is this thing, this which is covering the bonnet steam flow path area, and this is the steam flow area. When the pressure is exceeded, this will lift up and the excess steam will be released. So now let's see the formula. The first formula is that circumference of the valve into lift means what? This is the valve. The valve is sitting on this circumference of the flowing area, and this is the lift. What will be the lift? Suppose that is as a L. So lift will be suppose L. So this lift is suppose L. Okay, so this is the L, and the circumference of the valve is the area where it is sitting on the flow area. So this is the circumference of the valve. Now circumference of the valve into lift is equal to the area of the steam flow. So what is the area of the steam flow? This is the area of the steam flow. Okay, this is the area of the steam flow, and this is the circumference of the valve and into the lift. So now by placing the formula, circumference of the valve will be pi into diameter. Okay, as you know, 2 pi r is a formula basically of a circumference of a circular section. So 2 pi r into lift L, and area of the steam flow will be pi into diameter by pi r square. Basically pi r square, if we take in diameter form, it will be pi r square by 4. Okay, then we know pi get cancelled out, and after that diameter 2 times will cancel by 1, and it will come around lift is equal to diameter by 4. So we can say L is equal to D by 4. So what happened basically, this is the area of the steam flow, this is circular section. So the area of circular diameter is pi r square, and this is a circumference section where the valve is sitting on the this area, circular section. So the circumference area will be 2 pi r, and lift will be L. The 2 pi r into L by the area of the steam flow will be pi r square. Okay, so by adjusting the formula, we will get L is equal to D by 4 or radius by 2, you can say. So basically what happened, this indicates that whatever area provide for the steam to escape, the valve must lift to the extent that it will provide same area as the steam escape. So what this indicate is, this means the amount of area required by the steam flow should be equal to the area provided by the valve. So it means that the lift should be either lift should be D by 4. This is the lift which we will try to achieve so that we can provide maximum steam escape in a small amount of time. So if D by 3, then the size of the valve increases with no useful effect. Instead, the height of the valve will increase. So basically, if we design a valve with a diameter D by 3, it means that it is not causing any useful effect because we are increasing the height of the valve, but we are not increasing the efficiency of lift. If it is D by 5, then there will be restriction in the steam flow and it will create the back pressure. So what I mean by this, that suppose if we design a valve whose lift is D by 5, in that case we are decreasing the lifting area. If we are decreasing the lifting area, it means that we are preventing a restriction, we are building up a restriction for a steam flow. But if we design a system such that is d by 3, in that case, it means it is more efficient. No, it is not more efficient, because by the formula we have come that ideal maximum steam escape can be provided only lift is d by 4. If we design a valve such as d by 3, it is providing no useful effect. It will only increase the height of the valve. So our main aim of any safety valve design is that design such a valve that whose lift should be d by 4. So I hope you have learned that what is the difference between the safety valve and a relief valve, and what is do you mean by the lift of the valve, and how the lift of the valve is calculated, and why it is d by 4. If you have any doubt, please do comment below. I will reply. And please do subscribe. Please do subscribe and like. And I must want to say you that please share this with your friend also, so that they can come to this platform and can watch my video and we can learn and grow together. Thank you, friend. Have a good day.